Welcome to Real Talks with Kings, and thank you so much for joining us for the 12th episode. Thank you for the love. Please keep sharing the videos, keep commenting and subscribing to the channel. So you are joining us today from the co-working space situated at Sea Point in Maseru, Lesotho. So I'm going to ask our guests to introduce themselves and then I will tell you the topic of the day. Mamolefi, please just introduce yourself.
Okay, my name is Mamolefi Tesele from Roma, Lesotho. I am a mother of two boys, mm-hmm. a widow.
Yeah. Okay. So today we are going to tackle a very difficult topic. Since COVID-19, we have seen so many young women lose their spouses. So I invited Mema Tepo as a very young leader to come and share her story, what it's like losing a spouse. So can we start on the nice part? How did you meet your spouse? How was it sharing your life with your spouse?
Okay. I met my spouse when I was at NUL. Mm-hmm. I was doing first year, so that's where we met. Mm. And I got married, I think, when I was doing third year.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes, so our life, it was a very nice life. Mm-hmm. He was more of a friend than a husband. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the nicer part is, I think, he had a relationship a little bit different than mine with mm-hmm. the boys. Mm-hmm. Like, I left him with the boys when the younger one was 1 year old mm-hmm. and the older was seven. Mm-hmm. Not seven, but four.
Okay. Yeah. So... Can you tell us when you lost your spouse, if you still remember vividly that day, how was it like when you received the news that your spouse had passed on? And if you still remember, how long were you married at the time when you lost your spouse?
That day, you know how it came, okay. But the day, I think it was the worst ever. Hmm. Because, yes, he was sick, but I was hoping for something positive. Mm-hmm. And I left him around 8 p.m. Mm-hmm. And he was fine, and he showed nothing like he was going to leave. Mm-hmm. Then in the morning when I went to the hospital to check him, yeah, I think I was told I arrived something like 10 minutes after. Because when I got there, I found his bed was removed and no one could tell me what was happening. The only thing that I know I was asked was my relationship with him. Mm. And the people who asked me the relationship with him were the people who received me when I took him to the hospital. Mm-hmm. And it was the craziest question ever. Mm. Yeah, I stood for some time. They took me where he was, because the only question I was asking, where is him? So they ended up taking me to the place where he was. Mm. I asked for some time alone with him mm-hmm. in that room. Mm. I think I stood there like for 30 minutes or so. The body was still hot. I thought it was a mistake. Mm. He was going to wake up. Mm. And maybe after some, I think after 20 to 30 minutes, mm-hmm. the nurses came and they asked me to go out. Mm-hmm. Because I felt like not leaving, because I was thinking, this guy, there must be some mistake. This person is going to wake up and mm. see, no, I'm still alive. But then he wasn't. Mm. Yeah, that's how I received.
How long had you been married at the time?
We're married for 7 years.
And how old were you?
I was 29.
Ish, I can't imagine losing a spouse at 29. That's so sad. Let's get to this part. How were your first 3 to 6 months without your husband? And another one, how old were your kids? You said you have 2 boys. How old were they?
At that time, my firstborn was 7 years old and the little one was 3.
Hmm.
And the first 6 months, I don't think I even remember a lot because that time at some point I thought I was crazy or I was mad, let me just say that way.
Hmm.
Because kind of going where I would have the blackouts, like it's a lot of fun because I once had a blackout, I woke up because I don't know what happened. I just woke up, second to the pavement.
Oh.
And people were looking like, what's happening? But hey, the first 6 months, it was hell. Or even the first year was a hell because at some point, how time I work in Lavanadipaslo, we used to go together. So, you have to decide on your own. Everything was a mess.
I can't imagine what you were going through. So, coupled with you losing your husband at 29, there's usually this societal, what do I call it? Our society usually blames women. When your husband passes on. Actually, some people go on to say, did you experience that hateful thing?
Not really.
Okay.
I experienced that. But I think, it wasn't that easy because people never sent it. We had something like 6-7 months.
Okay.
So, everyone was like, ineka ye papaya or something. Because everyone was hugging, okay, mungamu, coughing. And that on its own, coupled with Matsidiso. Yes, I know Matsidiso came to him, clever to Matsidiso. Yes, it's what Sarona, but believe you me, how na mom and do what we go. People going in and out, how you mungwa kena, the other one is going out. You don't have your space, you don't have your time, you don't even have time to
cry.
Have time to cry, you don't have time and make sense of
the situation.
Yes, because from morning, but what feel, let alone how I can I be more like and obvious a fella.
Sure.
What happened? I was waiting to you, like, there was a time I thought, literally, because,
Let's get on to another tough part. When people lose their spouses, depending on your relationship with your in-laws, some in-laws are supportive, some are not. Usually, some even fight, for the leftover money and so many other things.
Everything.
What's your experience? Did you get the support?
Luckily, I had the in-laws who supported me throughout.
Okay.
And yes, they are not angels, but generally they supported me. And the best way, some people think it's negative, but on my side I think it was positive, was they gave me space. Just taking me from
a distance.
It gave me a time to be independent, and Laura gets me on how am I going to live from here? Basa khatatane le nna basa mpatle dinhotseng ata fa ya.
Okay. So in your healing process, did you find that you were meeting with other widows, or were you going for counseling as an individual? Like, how did you heal? I know you don't fully heal, and I'm sure you still miss your husband, but for you to be at this space where you can actually talk about the ordeal.
The healing part, I think, it depends on what you want. Because for me, I didn't go for counseling. Mm-hmm. Much as Kite, I thought at some point, like, do I get a thing or something. I didn't go for counseling, but I resorted to doing things that we used to do together, mm-hmm. our whole, and meet people by another way.
Okay.
That's how I think at some point I got healed. God's love. In the motor ball, I joined. It's an old stock team
mm-hmm.
at home.
Mm-hmm.
I think at the moment I'm the only woman in that team. Yeah,
that's amazing.
Because I felt like Hakile Monono, where
he loved.
He loved. Yes. So being with those people, interacting with such people, ilang for this, and being with Batwa, Baba Hata, also did. And most of the time, I used to interact with Bahotsi Bahai, le Bahotsi Baka. And then spending time with my boys, Khetama and everything, yeah.
Because this episode was actually inspired by a couple of messages I received on my inbox where people were telling me, can you please tell us where to go? Because we had like a 29-year-old like you who lost her husband through due to COVID. I think one lost their husband in December, one in January. Mm-hmm. So what do you say to people who are going through a similar situation that you went through? They are going through it now because of COVID. They are left with little children. What do you say to them?
All I can say, they should live their lives
mm-hmm.
and allow themselves to grieve.
Mm-hmm.
Grieve high fully.
Yeah,
sure. I still grieve. I still cry. Sometimes,
mm-hmm.
I relate, and then in the morning, I'm like, why am I crying? So they should also let themselves do it. Because happy they should live their lives. How late a widow? Because you're on the spotlight, everything you're doing is being marked. So as long as you have a time, do it.
Okay.
It's all open.
Okay. The last part, I can't close the show before we talk about this. You were 29. You can't expect that when you're 29, later on, when you heal and become better, you're not meeting other people. So can you talk about Mjola a bit? Is it hard for Jola, a household lady, to a widow? Or what do people expect during you're going to grieve for the rest of your life? You can't move on?
Yeah, the society expects you... Like I said, you're on the spotlight. How do you like a pele? They're like, how was a for you like a pele hagakan? How dear ha? Letting how to live pele ka pele wa hakeng? It's like utama pele according to hona mangu batang. So mjolo utata how le a widow? How hollow the first one? Because how get the whole. After losing your life partner, why bitter? You're bitter. You're like, you'll do it and you don't even feel like happy. There's a guilt. I don't know, the guilt. Yeah, really, it's like you're cheating someone. And hang at dating, because the person, how to see soaring, you're still craving. How bad you are on the profile pic, they'll be like, really, you computer, let's go and all that. So.
I can't imagine, it's a tough one, Mateb. But before we close, I know you guys started a support group or an organization that supports widows, especially young widows. Can you talk about that organization as we close? Where can they find you? What's your Facebook name? All those.
Yeah, we started something. It's an association registered with law office. We started it because it's something like a support group. Yes, just like you're saying. I think we were three widows from Roma. Haritala, this thing. As because Nerele Lohansa Rekota Kabumi Kanale different challenges. Zabupil. I might not have study in laws, but the other one, on other study in laws, Hosonale, the in laws to Amaki said in the demo, Asat Leo, Sotri Akunyala, things like that. Emo. Just like you said, so we thought if we can laugh at it and share the experiences, it got to seven. That's why we and we are still there. The organization, the association is called Widows Jane.
Widows Jane.
Yeah. So as who fall.
Okay.
Yeah, in this journey. Okay. How do we tackle the challenges that are difficult?
Okay. I think I will mention your Facebook name when I post the video.
Yeah.
But thank you so much, Mama Tapa, for coming to the show. I really appreciate this. This was an emotional one. It's not easy for me. I just got married. I cannot imagine losing my husband. So thank you for coming. Honestly, thank you so much. Real talk viewers, we thank you for watching. Please share the video, especially this one. These are tough times. And if you know someone that has recently lost a spouse, please share the video with them. This is just to encourage other people to say, you are not alone. There's an association where you can go and heal. And thank you. See you next week.